Tim, in the last two videos, we introduced a bit how Next.js is a good, a viable solution for building websites and apps, and also we talked about the AMP rendering for having more optimized rendering for search engines and also for your websites for better experience and more speed. Now I would like to focus more on using Next with other things. Other frameworks, other things, maybe like GraphQL or some people like styled components. Can you tell us about more about the things that people use Next with?
So we've seen many cases where people want to use like one library or the other, or like multiple different things. They might want to use Apollo for doing data fetching using GraphQL, or they want to use Redux, styled components for styling. Specifically for styling, we also include a library by default, which is called styled.jsx, which is another way to do styling in CSS, CSS and JS, basically. And we have an examples directory, which has, I think, over 190 examples right now. Which is, it's a crazy amount, but we all maintain them
So
still.
it's contributed by the community.
Yeah, most are contributed by the community. They're maintained by the community in many cases. For example, the Apollo example. When we accepted the Apollo example, I hadn't used Apollo before. So someone from the community actually like went in there and like created the example. We could review it because it's code, of course, so we can still review the code and see like if the implementation is good, and then like just merge them.
Right. So, for instance, if I need to use GraphQL, then I will go to that sample of using Apollo and I will kind of inspire from it in a
Yes.
way.
Yeah. So you would end up like copying the implementation, and then you're also aware of like what it does exactly instead of like having it abstracted away, for example.
Right. Okay. But you didn't. So you did in this matter, you don't take an opinion about that. If people want to use REST, you let them use REST. If they want to use Apollo and GraphQL, that's their choice.
So the only thing that we provide for data fetching is getInitialProps. And getInitialProps is just an asynchronous method. So you can do like anything that you want in there, basically, as long as it can be executed on the server and on the client side. Which means that it runs on your on the browsers of users, basically, also when you navigate between pages. So you can use like Apollo, but you can also do just like fetch the official fetch standard, and then get some data from somewhere.
When people start with Next, what are the things that they kind of struggle the most with, or what do they like spend their time in the beginning trying to understand? Are there like these kind of things that you What kind of advice you can give them when they're starting with the next app?
Really good question. So generally, what we do is we actually have a website called on next.js.org, like the main website. There's a button called Learn, and we have this amazing Learn section where you can do like a guided tour through like everything that Next does, like all the features. It has like quizzes to revalidate like your knowledge, and you get like points. And that is a really good way to get started with Next because it goes through everything, like the history behind it, like why we started it, like how specific things work, and that kind of thing. So it goes into like data fetching and yeah,
So these are,
everything.
it's a good resource to kind of
Yes.
look there for instead of like going to Stack Overflow or somewhere else. Now that
Yes.
helps too, right?
Yeah. So basically, when you start, you do the full course. Because it's like sort of like a course, and it goes into like from very basic to more advanced, and it covers like many different things.
Nice. Any other advice you would tell people when they use Next?
Yeah,
Anything?
so we have this, like I said, we have this examples directory, which is on GitHub,
Also, yeah.
and it has these 190 examples that you can take and then like make your own, basically. And that is where most people like start off. They like start off with an example because they want to do something specific. Maybe they want to use Redux, and then they like use the Redux example and then go from there.
Do they need to learn React? If they don't know React, imagine just jump directly to Next, or they should both learn both?
It really depends. Next makes it very easy to get started with React, actually, because we just use components. So you can write like any React component would work in Next, as long as you use the just the React lifecycle methods.
Right. Okay.
So that means that if you get started, all you have to do is like install Next, run Next, create your pages directory, create this file, which is called index, for example, and you export a React component and it works immediately. And you see like you see the results immediately.
So instead of like going through
for example, having to set up your all this compilation things that we talked about in the previous video. So it's a good those way are to like start. Barriers to get started, right?
So it's a good it's an option to start directly from Next without like trying to experiment
with is there before. The best thing that you can do is get very familiar with the component system. So how to write React components. And when you know how to write React components, you know how to write Next.js applications.
Right. Or the other whenever you can write Next applications, you know how to write React. Anyway.
Yeah. And then also Next has some like APIs on top of it. So for example, you have like a head component and a link component, and it's only like there's a few components that we provide in Next by default, which are just there to help you. So for example, head will inject the tags that you render in there as the head tags of your page.
Okay. Yeah. Well, nice. Well, thank you very much for all this knowledge.
Thank you.